It is a good question, but at movement you can see there are there was many articles about this in the past, at present as well. But I think last week one of the leading newspaper we have responded very well about these market opportunities and the wrong perceptions published by certain people and the medias and all that. Therefore, as we are in the industry, we are very confident about the market and all are starting new project. So there is a huge opportunity to come up, because since we are only doing single digit residency apartment in Sri Lanka. Single digit mean our occupancy or the market share of the total market is only still below 10%. But if you look at, as I told you many times, in other developed countries, Hong Kong, Malaysia, Singapore, in Dubai and all that, there is almost 30-40%. Because the residency in Sri Lanka, it is not affordable by individual to buy a land and build a house, because it is so expensive, especially in the city. So therefore, the customers or whoever want to live in city due to their employment or education or whatever reason, they forced to go for the apartment because of the affordability. Therefore, we are very confident still we needed many more apartments to live. Of course, the demand is always there, and because if we always, the problem in Sri Lanka is the academics or policy makers who always copy the European laws and following their strategies without understanding the local condition. But you can remember the pestle factors we studied in the strategic management, called pestle factors: political, economical, social, technological, environmental and the legal factors, which have more impact than the general environment. So even though general environment analyzed by the pestle factors, we should be localized some of the factors to suit for the local condition. For example, sometime it very unfortunate we just copy the European financial and fiscal policies here, where those countries have interest rate only 3-4%. We are Sri Lanka, we are talking about 18% to 28%. So absolutely it is irrelevant. So therefore, when you implement those type of irrelevant policies, the market can lead to wrong perceptions and the difficulties. You can remember the market somewhere in Dubai and so many countries created bubble. Bubble is never happen automatically. It is inappropriate political, economical, especially legal policies implemented by the government. If you say, best example, Dubai or even Canada. Canada brought non-occupancy tax. Like that, UK brought double residence tax. So which is done by the government only. Whereas it has led to a drop in the market for the demand. So innovative guys like Dubai and all that, they always think upward, how to create demand. So you know the best example, the Apple, how they created the demand. They didn't look at the cheap or expensive. Even the phones are available for 2,000, 3,000 rupees, but they were selling at the rupees of 1 lakh. It is a very great example. The people are talking about luxury apartment, doesn't have any demand and all that. It's how you market. In other words, it's called STP, segment, target, positioning in the marketing principles. So how you position your product in the global market. The apartment high-end market, still there is a demand. If we talk about beautiful city, we talk about 2020 and 2025. We needed a total infrastructure development. So basically, not only some people think the apartments developers are only buying and selling apartment. No, we are partly main partners of the infrastructure development. You will ask, what do you mean by that? Example, when that area, a new apartment come, we develop the road, drainage system, water supply, electricity, transformers, and etc. etc. Therefore, the whole total area, it is become a demand for the public. So shopping malls are coming like that. So the different companies are following different strategy. Only thing the government should understand how to position and take forward this good work done by the developers. I think we made a big mistake in the past 1.5 years back, stating the real estate sector and the construction industry is high risk. Whereas the true fact is the bank facing the liquidity issues, it was evidenced by last one of the newspaper. We are to overcome that situation, unfortunately the banks created a story this particular industry is a risky industry. Therefore, they want really to stop withdrawing money and invest it in real estate, where it is a true fact, real estate is giving much higher returns, mostly 22, even 40 to up to 80% some of the developments. So therefore, bank is only paying a 16% interest rate, or deposit rate is very low, even 40% now. Therefore, people started withdrawing the money from the bank and started buying real estate at a rate. The only way to bank is to stop this, just stopping the lending for developers, where they can't do more development. The people won't withdraw the money from the bank. And also they said another way, just saying the real estate industry is high risk and bubble is coming and all that. Therefore, people got panic. I don't think which has a true fact. Even one of the customer recently spoke with me and said, you know, Mr. Thumilan, very difficult to withdraw money from the bank to invest in the real estate. I asked why. Because always they discourage. But I said, finally, it is my money. Please allow me to withdraw. Mm-hmm. You see, these type of malpractices and unethical practices create a tarnished image about our industry. Not only locally, it is affected internationally as well. Therefore, we should focus and help the industry, which has brought 30% almost GDP growth together. Not only that, it is a free cash flow to the country, FDI. We are bringing a lot of foreign currency which are not loaned, we don't need to repay. I will say around 90% of the foreign currencies brought by the real estate developers are still staying in Sri Lanka itself.
That is for your developments, or are you talking about people coming and buying your apartments?
People coming and buying their apartment in Sri Lanka, very rarely they will take out the money. So the whole money is taking, so exchange rates and can be, you know, inflow is very high. Actually, if you see, it is really an indirect export.
Yeah, I mean, even rental yields are higher, I think.
The rental rates are high. Not only that, we are doing so many, and tourism, we are indirectly promoting the tourism industry. Earlier, the people came to stay only 1 week or 5 weeks, or 1 week or 2 weeks. Now they are staying 6 months. Or sometimes they are staying as their retirement home 6 months over here. We have an apartment in Mount Lavinia. Most of the foreigners are paying huge rent to our customers and coming for the treatment. And also they want to have a lifestyle, beach, swimming and all that. So they are enjoying really a tourism. Which was, we had a very short stay tourism in the hotel life, but in the apartment they having a long stay lifestyle, which is giving a lot of foreign currencies and other income to Sri Lanka. As a macro environment factors, one is the pestle, in that one is legal, because VAT also coming under the legal, because it's a legislation. So what it unfortunately is, when a lot of taxes implement, the government think they can generate, or policymakers advise government you can earn more revenues, but it is not the reality. The last time we implemented so many taxes which never reached the target, people, we have to see the decline correlations also. When you do this one, what is the sensitive analysis, how much it will affect the sales, how much foreign investment can be taken out, like that we never analyze. Now see, if the VAT definitely going to be impact to the apartment sale, because not only VAT, please, so many businesses only have VAT. In apartments, the developer, when he buying a land, is paying 4% stamp duty to the government. Again, we are paying, when we develop also, the customer is paying 4% stamp duty on the valuation done by the Western province or whoever, valuer. So they are not paying the 4% stamp duty again on the apartment, not the purchase value, the market value mostly. These are done by the stamp duty. So theoretically, you are collecting twice a stamp duty. When the developer buying the land, you are paying stamp duty, we are paying stamp duty, and again then the customer is paying stamp duty. With addition to this one, you are trying to implement VAT, NPT, ESE, and so many other taxes. Definitely you are going to hit the industry or trying to make the industry to suicide, which is not a real advice to the country. And also most of the developed countries or other countries, the apartments are exempted from the VAT. They have other taxes, but the apartment always is, residentials are always exempted. So today we are competing in the global market. The global investors or experts, what we are talking about, they will evaluate the world market. So we can't say the bubble came in Sri Lanka because we are making the bubble. So we should avoid these inappropriate tax policies and the legislation policies and all that. We have to make more attractive policies to bring foreign expats and investors to Sri Lanka. If you look at the today investors' point of view, BOI has removed tax holidays. So there is no more tax holidays for the any investors, especially developers. And we are paying so many direct and indirect taxes to the government. With addition to that one, the bankers or bank sector, banks as classified as risk and high risk industry, they are trying to charge artificial interest charges to the developers and the customers. Therefore, if you look at the overall picture, we want to kill an industry purposely or intentionally. I don't know, we will realize in later on, inflation, unemployment, foreign exchange will be
reduced.
It will be reduced, we're going to hit some more because the inflows, if when you reduce, the outflows are high. The biggest industry is the real estate industry. Not only the construction industry, also bringing a lot of money. Our people are doing overseas projects. So therefore, as you said, the question, that will have a serious impact on the sales, even whatever happened. So we should target whether we are expecting the economic growth and infrastructure development to the country or merely a tax collection to the country. Actually, the demand is created. You will study Michael Porter's Diamond Theory.
Okay.
In the Diamond Theory, the demand is created by, as I told you earlier, the government policies. So you can remember some time back, the former government is started in Hambantota, where the Hambantota started getting more demand for the land and the infrastructure development and all that. So therefore, we can't say this is the location. At present, of course, the Colombo city is high demand due to the schools, leading school, leading hospitals and etc. But it is the government policy how to develop the urban development and diverse the location to more attractive. And you can see in the past, we were some time back, the Kandy was the highest demand.
Yes.
In the past. Then Polanaruwa was in the demand. So it has, you can see in the past, it has moved several locations in our Sri Lankan history. So only doing development in the city, I don't think it is called urban development.
Urbanization is
very important.
Urban crowd, no?
Yeah.
It's a
very important.
Cities, yes.
Very important.
Yes,
but unfortunately, the people only focus on city. The rent income, the development cost and all that will go always goes up. So people may become difficult to afford and their lifestyle may be very, you know, in a dynamic world. Socializations and all that can have an indirect impact. We urge government kindly to support the high growth industry, which is bringing you a high GDP and foreign direct investment and other infrastructure development, I will say even employment. So we need to protect this industry in a very systematic manner by implementing consistency economic policy.